you guys. I was just out here at this pond, or this little swampy area here I was at. I just recently started going to this place because it looked really good for a lot of really cool amphibian species. And my target species today was the greater siren. I know they're in here somewhere, because usually any ponds you find newts in and stuff. A lot of other places like this, really with the high, dense, weed-choked vegetation swamps, usually are good for sirens. And I actually found a really, really cool species of amphibians. Actually one of Florida's most most cryptic amphibians, and it's this. This is the narrow-striped dwarf siren.
Hey guys, well, here's the narrow-striped dwarf siren. There are actually a few different species of dwarf siren here in the state of Florida. Just to name a few, you have the Gulf Hammock Dwarf Siren, which is found in the Gulf Hammock region of Florida, which is like Marion County, Levy, other places like that. This being the narrow-striped dwarf siren, which inhabits central Florida. And then you also have the Everglades Dwarf Siren, which are found obviously in South Florida. Now the dwarf siren, like other sirens, live in swamps that have a lot of vegetation, duckweed. I don't really know a lot of the aquatic plants, but usually places where you find newts, you will find sirens at. That's something I found that's pretty helpful. The dwarf siren gets approximately 7 inches long, so it is the smallest of the siren species. There's also the greater siren and the lesser siren. Obviously the greater siren, which can reach 3 feet, which is a big for a salamander. Dwarf sirens and all other sirens are extremely carnivorous. They eat a lot of tadpoles, including a lot of other amphibians. They eat crayfish, small fish. They have such a broad menu of food. They invertebrate, other invertebrates like worms. I mean, you name it, they're eating it. Now, just a quick fact about the narrow-striped dwarf siren. You can identify this dwarf siren. One, because of range. If you know you're in central Florida, you're not going to find an Everglades dwarf siren. But the narrow-striped dwarf siren has lines that run along its back like this, which is one of the distinguishing facts between that and the other dwarf sirens, because a lot of other dwarf sirens do have stripes, but they're not as slender and thin like
typical
the lines on the
ponds like this are very, very good for sirens and other amphibians, mostly places that are not stocked with predatory fish such as bass and grass pickerel, bluegill. You're going to have good amphibians in it. But this is typical habitat for it. You see, you have a lot of plants like this here. Those are pretty good. But you see, this place is just excellent habitat. It doesn't have too much sun that hits it due to all the trees that have grown out here. But yeah, that's about it for the dwarf siren, so let's go ahead and put this guy